What's up everyone, welcome back to the channel, and today I'll show you the best way to play Silent Hill 2 on PC. Without a doubt, the best alternative out there right now is using the PC port of the game with the Enhanced Edition Project mod. This makes the game compatible with modern hardware and fixes the issues with the original PC port, while also bringing several enhancements too, like 60 FPS, widescreen, high resolution textures, improved controller support, and more. And the installation is very straightforward. I'll guide you through everything as always, so subscribe to the channel and leave a like on this video, and let's get started. Now, the first thing that you're gonna need to have it with you is obviously a PC copy of Silent Hill 2, but preferably you should use one that is called Silent Hill 2 Fully Extracted Version. And I can't show you here on the video or even mention where you can get it because that's against YouTube's policy, but it shouldn't be very hard to find if you look around, if you know what I mean. Leave it like this, and now we're going to download the Enhanced Edition Setup Tool. And right here on this download and usage page, you're gonna scroll down a little bit right here where it says using Silent Hill 2 Enhanced Edition, and you're gonna click here on download this setup too. It's going to come in a single .exe file. We'll go ahead and place it on that same Silent Hill 2 folder. Now back here on the game folder, I put the setup file right here. So this one is very straightforward. You're just gonna double click this file and it's going to start the setup installation for it. Select the language and click OK. This window will show up. Click on next, and right here click on I accept the agreement to it, and here click on the first option here on the recommended tab, and here it's going to ask you where the game files are, and by default it should already found this folder that we are right here, but if it's not, go ahead and browse through it and select this one, and then just click on next. Here you can select what enhancements you want this pack to use. Keep it on the recommended tab right here with all of these options enabled, and click on next. Go now, click on install, and there you go. And to install this, you have to be connected to the internet because it's going to download the necessary files right here. It's going to depend on your computer too, and also how fast your internet is, but it's basically this, you know, 3.6 gigabytes of file. There you go, installation is complete. You can start playing the game, but before that, let's just tweak a few of the settings here. Uncheck this option here and check the open the configuration tool right here. And this basically has all the changes that this mod makes into. On the display tab, everything here is good to go. I would only recommend to enable the SMAA anti-aliasing here, unless you have that enabled on your GPU. Same for audio as well, everything enabled. And here on input, if you're using a Xbox controller, you can change it right here from direct input to X input. But if you're using a DualShock controller, leave it as direct input as well. On the menu tab, keep everything on. Game fixes too, and also mix as well, everything enabled. And also for the advanced tab, pretty much good to go right here. So just click on save. And to open the game, you have to double click here on this sh2pc.ex. And this is going to work pretty much out of the box right here. And there's some extra settings here too on options. The control type, the rotational here, 3D, is basically tank controls, like the original Resident Evil games, for example. And directional is probably what you want to use here, you know, controlling with the analog and all. Some settings here too on advanced options. By default, the noise effect will be set to off. And if you want to play more like the PS2 version of the game, I preferably like keeping this at off. Everything else should be set as on here too. You can also remap the controls here on control options. You just gotta highlight the option and then press enter, I believe. Yeah, there you go. And then press the button you want to change either on the keyboard or on your controller right here. And that is pretty much it. You can now start the game, see how good this one looks and plays really well too. Nice optimization and everything. So go ahead and have fun with it. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel and also leave a like on this video too. I would really appreciate it. Have fun. And as always, I'll see you in Silent Hill.